Hello everyone, my name is Hack, Salamalaysia Madani. Are you tired of your boring looking Steam user interface? Or ever want or dreamed to make it look more personalized for the sake of your eyes? Well, fear not! Today I'm going to teach you how to add custom backgrounds, also known as themes, and also custom QOL quality of life plugins for your Steam client. Be aware that this is my first time making a full voice tutorial and I'm sorry if I sound awkward or nervous because I really am. So before we get started, if you found this video useful, please leave a like or a comment for it. That means a lot to me and a small support for my future content. So thank you and let's get moving. Alright, so to make your Steam client have like custom backgrounds and such and plugins, you need a tool that is called Millennium. So what you're going to do is to type in Millennium install for Steam in your Google tab, as you can see it here, and you can just click install now, and there will be a pretty easy installation method which is basically automatic. I'm not going to teach you the manual one because I haven't really tried it, but I guess it's not that complicated. You're just going to be downloading the repository and extract them to your PC Steam folder, yeah. But I'm just going to show you the much more modern method, which is by using PowerShell installator script. First, we'll copy this and then we will type in Windows PowerShell shit typo. Windows PowerShell here, and we're just going to Control V in the thing. It will close our Steam process. That's pretty neat, not gonna lie. And that's it. And now you are going to start Steam again, which is here, and it should have the plugins that you will need for custom background. And yeah, oh, here it is. Yes, that's our Steam. As you can see, nothing seems to be changed because we haven't installed anything yet, like literally. So we will just go to Steam and you should see a bar called Millennium here. Okay, this is pretty awkward. It normally will pop out window instead of full screen, but yeah, that means you basically have the add-on that you will need to install themes and plugins. Yeah, it's pretty much like the fan call in Discord. Yeah, the one that you can install custom themes, yeah, it's pretty similar. So now to actually find themes, you need to go install theme, and yeah, as you can see they have their own custom website for themes. So, and this is one of the theme I'm currently using. It's called Space Theme, and if we want to download it, we can just copy theme ID, go back here, Steam Millennium themes in something, and then we'll just copy and we'll just paste it here, and it should be installing. I'll show you the theme in a second here. Most of these themes are also constantly updating, and Millennium will constantly automatically check for the available updates. And as you can see, the apply is instant. You don't even need to restart Steam or whatsoever. Except it just takes some time to load here because I have a garbage PC. Yeah. As you can see here in the friend list, this is definitely some changes. It looks more modern and dark. Yeah, OLED dark, I guess. Yeah, why is Steam not opening? Steam, you. Okay, maybe it needs to restart. Okay. As you can see, shit, looks nice, eh? You have this modern-ish feel and very dark theme, and look at this, oh my god, this is just perfect, you know? This is so cool, yeah. So you can You can, I have all these new icons here. Playtime, yeah, see. And they basically changed everything in your UI. Almost everything, like, see, the library tab is constantly showing up. And yeah, the soundtrack, this is also definitely some changes. Oh shit, yeah, even the almost everything has changed. But I'm not sure about big screen mode though. Big picture mode, I mean, I don't really use that feature anyway, so yeah. Okay. And now next, I'll show plugins. Now, for plugins, yeah, it's basically like small little add-ons that is QOL, as you can see, SteamDB extension. I'm sure you, most of you is familiar with SteamDB. It basically shows you, yeah, the lowest recorder price, the player stats, and that. So yeah, and it's the same, you just copy the ID and come here and confirm the installation. So if I like this, yeah, look, as you can see here, wait, hold on. As you can see here, it has the SteamDB extension plugins. See, it will show you the lowest recorded price is when and it's when it happened. The SteamDB rating, the player stats, and basically a lot of QOL stuff that you will need to know before buying a game. And it even have a, you can just click view on SteamDB and it will open this Steam overlay thing for you to see a SteamDB. I'm sure most of you are familiar by this now. So yeah, that's basically it. It is a pretty neat add-on, I think, in my opinion. It makes your Steam like brand new, so if you ever get tired of your old Steam, you can always find some very good community made stuff out here. Like take this as example. My Steam has never ever been this bright before. This is like opening white wait no light mode in Steam. Okay, this might not have that much space of it. It uses the same old Steam thing, but the background, I guess you guys can also try to figure it out to how to make some pretty cool custom theme for you for your old weapons, because it's basically, yeah, that's basically it. I'm just gonna use it back first. Yeah, and it's just set as active, you start now. And that's basically it. Sorry for the awkward speaking I have, since this is actually like my first ever video that's gonna speak for full time and explaining stuff to you all. So I hope you guys enjoy your day, and I hope you guys are feeling good in the future. Yeah, that's it. Bye bye.